Hello, so today is 80s day again, and this cruise, we've only had about 2 days break from doing 80s because we had a Cuba cruise, which means our shows are a different kind of order to what we'd usually have. Today I thought I'd show you what my kind of sound check entails. So I actually filmed that about 10 minutes ago and you'll be able to see that. So we usually start off in a group and all 8 of us will sing one of the group numbers from whatever show we're doing that day. So today it's 80, so we all sang Man in the Mirror, which is the finale number. And we all kind of listen to our mixes and see what we need more or less of. So we have to work on our levels, such as like bass levels, how much track you want, how much of each person in the cast you want, and then work on kind of like how you want to hear your voice, if you want more like reverb and things like that. So, sorry. So yeah, just work on like how much reverb you want in your own ears and how loud you want yourself in your own ears, and then kind of what tone you want to hear for yourself, and then it all comes out through the speakers and Denzel, our sound technician, mixes it all together and makes it sound amazing. So after we've done our group sound check, we'll then all the singers have an opportunity to do one of their songs from the show, just to check that their levels are good when they're singing solo stuff, because it does sound different when there's other people singing on top of you than when it's just predominantly you. So I filmed me singing Dance With Somebody, and recently I've been having a few problems with a bit of interference with my packs and stuff, so I just wanted to check that I'd all been ironed out, and it has, thankfully. Because sometimes sound issues like that can really throw you off. Like, one time I had loads of reverb and I was like out of tune because I was singing on top of things that I'd already sung, and it was really putting me off. And then sometimes, like before, I've like changed the level by accident on my actual pack like halfway through the show and not realised, from quick changes and stuff, and it's literally like blowing my ears off on stage. I've got to take an ear out. Oh, it's not good. So that's why we have sound checks, to avoid kind of like surprises once you get on stage, and also yeah, just to make sure that you're happy with how you're going to sound, and then you can focus more on giving your best shot on the stage rather than worrying about what you can hear.
Yeah.
have got about 10 minutes before I need to get dressed for the show, so I'm just gonna chill in the audience for a bit. My hair is gonna come down soon. I just plait it and put it on top of my head because it's actually, the hair piece is really heavy. So yeah, I usually just braid it and then just stick on top of my head till I'm ready, and then it comes down into a big ponytail. Also, I have become a massive fan of, please focus, not me. There we are. Of kombucha since I've come to the US, and I don't really think I've seen it in England. We might have it, but I've not really seen it. And I like to have one just to, sometimes if you're a bit seasick, it makes me feel better. This one is a ginger spice one. Usually they're a lot bigger than that, but I found, if anybody cares about kombucha, in Publix, I found baby kombuchas. This is like a concentrated kombucha shot because I don't want to drink a whole one before a show because it's quite a lot of volume. But yeah, so that's just, you know, my daily snack tip for you. Just realised today I seem to be having some eyelash problems, which I'm not prepared to fix because I just can't be bothered. Which one is it? Just apologise to the entire 1500 seat audience for the state of my eyelash today. It's okay, you won't see it. You won't see it. You won't see it from the audience. It's gonna be fine. I'm just filming some kind of explanations about why we do our sound checks, and then kind of like, you know, what a sound check entails and what sort of levels you want and things like that. Do you have any disasters on stage because of your
have
sound?
I ever?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, yeah. Let's see, sometimes you don't know what your tonal center is, so that means that you don't know what key you're in. So that means that
very fun.
You're singing something, but it sounds completely clashing against the music or the background vocals or everybody else. Sometimes you don't hear yourself at all, so then you push too much, which it's actually very detrimental to the vocals because you're trying to compensate or overly compensate for what you're singing out there. Basically, the sound is everything. If we can't hear ourselves, we can't sing.
Precisely. So. Thank you for that insight.
You're welcome.